TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surabhi Sharma. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Thursday, the 5th of March. India reports 30 coronavirus cases, all international passengers to be screened. Activists demand UN intervention to prevent genocide in Balochistan. And U.S. reaffirms commitment to facilitate Afghan prisoner exchange. And now for all the details. India on Thursday confirmed 30 coronavirus cases after a man in northern Ghaziabad city was tested positive. New Delhi has suspended all regular as well as e-visas for all passengers travelling from or having visited Italy, Iran, South Korea and Japan to contain the spread of the deadly virus.
India on Thursday reported 30 cases of the novel coronavirus after a resident of northern Ghaziabad city was tested positive. New Delhi, in addition to its visa restrictions already in place, has suspended visas of all passengers travelling from or having visited Italy, Iran, South Korea and Japan now to contain the spread of the deadly virus, India's Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan said in Parliament on Thursday. The minister said the travel advisory, which suspends all visas issued on or before March 3rd, is a temporary measure till cases of COVID-19 subside. India, as on 4th March, brought a total of 28,529 persons under community surveillance amid coronavirus outbreak. The country has so far reported 30 confirmed cases of the deadly virus, which includes 16 Italians.
And as situation is evolving, the travel advisories are accordingly getting revised. Presently, it prescribes all regular visas / e-visas, including visa on arrival for Japan and South Korea, granted to nationals of Italy, Iran, South Korea, Japan, and issued on or before 3rd of March 2020, and who have not yet entered India, stand suspended with immediate effect.
As the fear of coronavirus rises in India, citizens have started taking precautions like wearing masks or cover their faces with handkerchiefs to counter the threat of the infection spread. More than 93,000 cases have been reported worldwide and several thousands have died from coronavirus, which emerged in China's Wuhan late last year.
India on Wednesday lambasted Pakistan for raking up the Kashmir issue at the United Nations Human Rights Council and asked the country to rather work constructively and devote equal attention to protection and promotion of human rights of its own minorities.
India on Wednesday slammed Pakistan over its interference in the Kashmir issue at the United Nations Human Rights Council or UNHRC in Geneva and asked the country to rather work towards protecting the human rights of its own minorities. Exercising the right to reply at the 43rd UNHRC session, First Secretary in India's permanent mission to the UN, Vimarsh Aryan, said, at a time when Pakistani delegation is raising false concerns for the rights of human rights defenders elsewhere, its own human rights defenders are bearing the brunt of real draconian laws. The diplomat brought to the session's notice the repeated references by the international community of the enforced disappearances and extrajudicial killings of activists carried out by the Pakistani security agencies.
Jammu and Kashmir has been, is and will continue to be an integral part of India, and Pakistan should cease to covet it. We ask Pakistan that instead of spewing lies for its self-serving mendacious propaganda, work constructively and devote equal attention to protection and promotion of rights of human rights defenders, including those from minorities in Pakistan.
to the delegation of Pakistan.
Pakistan, in its another attempt to internationalize the Kashmir issue, had demanded the UNHRC to set up a commission of inquiry to look into what it termed as Indian brutality in the Kashmir region. Islamabad has opposed India's decision in August last year to abrogate special status of Jammu and Kashmir to integrate the region more closely with it. But India has maintained it was an internal matter.
Moving on, Baloch activists held a demonstration outside the United Nations building in Geneva to seek the world body's intervention to prevent the ongoing genocide of Baloch people by Pakistan in Balochistan. They highlighted gross human rights violations by the Pakistani army in the region to muscle dissenting voices.
A group of Baloch activists held a protest during the 43rd UNHRC session in Geneva, demanding the international human rights body to intervene and stop the ongoing genocide in Balochistan by the Pakistani state and its forces. The demonstrators highlighted torture, enforced disappearances and killings of scores of political activists and intellectuals by the Pakistani army to muzzle dissenting voices. They said there has been a sharp rise in human rights violations in Balochistan since the launch of the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, or CPEC, which has also led to displacement of Baloch people.
The people who are there, they are deprived of their basic rights. They do not get water, they do not get medicines. But on the other hand, the Pakistan is forcing them, eliminating them, asking them to leave these places because they need those lands for her strategic purposes. Unfortunately, China is on the backside of Pakistan and asking Pakistan to eliminate these people.
The activists laid stress on urgent UN intervention to save the lives of Baloch people.
It's hell that's going on there. 40 million Baloch, they are just in concentration of Pakistan and Iran also. So this is the time that United Nations should understand and United Nations should feel their responsibility to come to Balochistan and intervene.
The Baloch have been fighting against the forceful occupation of the land by Pakistan. They claim attempts to highlight the situation in Balochistan have long been repressed.
U.S. Special Envoy Zelmay Khalilzad has said Washington is still committed to facilitating the disputed prisoner exchange that was agreed in February 29 peace deal between United States and the Taliban. His remarks came as the Afghan government has rejected the clause and the Taliban has resumed attacks across Afghanistan.
U.S. Special Envoy Zelmay Khalilzad has said the United States is still committed to facilitating the disputed prisoner exchange that was agreed in the February 29th peace deal between Washington and the Taliban. Khalilzad, in a series of tweets on Thursday, said the U.S. will support both the Afghan government and the Taliban to release significant number of prisoners. The envoy's remarks come as Afghan government remains unmoved from its stance of no Taliban prisoners release prior to the start of the intra-Afghan talks. Following the government's rejection over the prisoners' release, the Taliban resumed attacks on government forces. On Wednesday, U.S. forces also conducted an airstrike against Taliban fighters in southern Helmand province, the first time in 11 days since the two sides had agreed to a reduction in violence plan that started on February 22nd. Holi, the festival of colors, has commenced with the installation of the ritualistic wooden pole Chir in Nepal this week. The community responsible for erecting this age-old tradition is worried as the bamboo used to make the sacred chair is running out.
Hundreds of people gathered at the Basantapur Darbar Square in Nepal's capital Kathmandu on Tuesday to witness erecting of a wooden pole called chair that marks the beginning of Festival of Colours Holi. Chir is a special kind of bamboo pole having colourful cloth pieces hanging in three different circular layers and looks like an umbrella. It is erected by the community known as Dhala Siko Manandhars. They have now formed a registered committee known as Dhala Siko Manandhar Sanagu Khala to carry out the ritual. Dhala Siko Manandhars, who have been continuing this age-old tradition, are worried as the bamboo used to make the sacred chair is running out.
पहिला त गभर्नमेन्टले नै ल्याइदिने हो पछि आएर चाहिँ हामीले नै खोज्न जाने भयो होइन अनि अहिले त्यो चाहिँ चार पाँच वर्ष भयो त्यो चाहिँ चलिरहेको त्यस्तो निरन्तरता भइरहेको अब यो के छ भन्दाखेरि बाँस चाहिँ अहिले काठमाडौँमा छ नै छैन यो भालु बाँस भन्ने चाहिन्छ यो बनाउनलाई यो छ नै छैन
Hindus all over the world, including Nepal, celebrate this festival of colors with great enthusiasm. However, the main celebration in Nepal begins a week after the erection of chair.
Apart from enthralling adventures and impressive mountain boundaries, India's northern Leh city is known for its festivals. Hundreds of Buddhist followers and tourists converged at the famous Thok Korpuk Monastery to witness 2 days Thok Guru Sechu festival held this week.
Hundreds of Buddhist followers and tourists from across the world converged at the Thok Korpuk Monastery in India's northern cold desert city of Leh on Tuesday to witness Thok Guru Sechu festival. Masked dancers in colorful silk robes enthralled spectators at the two-day festival. Thok Guru Sechu festival is held every year in the first month of the Tibetan lunar calendar, the holy month of prayer. It is celebrated to mark the birthday of Guru Rinpoche, also known as Padma Sambhava.
ये हमारे लिए सबसे बड़ी ये फेस्टिवल मना जा रहा है तो इसलिए बाहर से भी बहुत सारे दर्शक आ रहे थे इस साल तो फिर भी मौसम बहुत अच्छा रहा
Monks dressed up in elaborate robes and masked recreated legends associated with different gods through dance performances.
It's my first time in Ladakh and I'm very excited about the festival. Came here with my guide Rinchen and yeah, I wish people well today. I hope this year, this coming year is good.
Two oracles, mostly laymen who are prepared by the priest to receive spirits of deities and who meditate for 2 months ahead of the festival, are the main highlight of the carnival. Devotees come to these oracles for predictions about the future.
Celebrating an age-old tradition, scores of women in India's northern Barsana town playfully beat up menfolk with sticks as they protected themselves with shields as part of celebration of Hindu festival Holi. The festival celebrates the eternal love of Hindu Lord Krishna and his consort Radha. Hundreds of people assembled in Barsana town in India's northern Mathura district on Wednesday to play Latmar Holi, a way of celebrating the Hindu festival of colors Holi, in which women chase away the menfolk by beating them with sticks. Celebrating an age-old tradition, men from neighboring towns and villages come to Barsana and sing provocative songs to invite the attention of women. The women go on the offensive and use long sticks called lathis to beat up the menfolk who protect themselves with shields. The spring festival celebrates the eternal love of Hindu Lord Krishna and his consort Radha.
Radha Rani ke roop mein ye gopiyan barsane nand gaon ke ghoriyaron pe laatiyan barsayengi barsare puri taiyari ho gayi aap dekhen ye saubhagyashali laatiyan khane ke liye ghoriyare utsuk hain aap hum sab log uska anand le rahe hain
This particular sequence gives Barsana's holy celebration the appellation of latmar or hitting with sticks.
फिर वो अपनी मजबूत लाठियों से प्रहार करती हैं हमारे पास ढाल है ढाल पे उन्हें झेलते हैं कन्हैया लाल का जयकारा करते हैं और इस समय जब तक ये लीला चलती है सूर्यास्त नहीं होता है
Holi will be celebrated across India on March 10th this year. On the occasion, people put colors on each other, distribute sweets and take out processions. Dancing to drum beats in a melange of colors. Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. India reports 30 coronavirus cases, all international passengers to be screened. Activists demand UN intervention to prevent genocide in Balochistan. And US reaffirms commitment to facilitate Afghan prisoner exchange. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.